Now, in that video, I'm providing you an example that shows you how to apply PCA to extract statistical factors from a panel of data. So, assume you are an equity portfolio manager and your asset universe is the Russell 3000. Hence, you need to model the expected returns, volatilities, pairwise correlations, and any higher moment that you're interested in of these 3000 stocks. Therefore, let's collect the time series for T being element 1 to cap T of realized returns of these K1000 stocks in a T times K matrix, which we call X. So here's what X looks like. Now, first, we're going to demean X and call the resulting T times K matrix X DM. DM stands for demeaned. So here's what XDM looks like. And note that RJ upper bar for any J element 1 to K is simply the sample mean of stock J's return. And the I index T times 1 is just a column vector with ones of dimension T times 1. Now, second, the K times K covariance matrix of all Russell 3000 stock returns is what we call sigma. And sigma is a full and potentially multicollinear. Now, remember, if the time series of one stock return can be nearly replicated by, or ideally can be perfectly replicated by, a linear combination of the other 2,999 stock returns, then you face a problem because the covariance matrix will not be invertible, because the rank of the matrix will be less than 3,000. I recommend you test that yourself. And I would be surprised if the rank of such a covariance matrix was larger than 100. So let's look what the covariance matrix sigma looks like. Yeah, here's what it looks like. And we can rewrite that as 1 divided by T XDM transpose times XDM. Now, by construction, each covariance matrix is symmetric. Hence, it has the following eigenvalue decomposition, where E is the matrix of eigenvectors and lambda is the diagonal matrix of eigenvalues. I would like to highlight already at that point that I recommend you sort lambda and E such that all eigenvalues are sorted in descending order. So the first element of lambda coincides with the largest eigenvalue, and the first column of E should coincide with its respective eigenvector. Now, the goal of a PCA is to rotate XDM into another matrix, which we call X tilde DM. And it shall be rotated such that the resulting covariance matrix of X tilde DM is diagonal. So mathematically, it means that X tilde will look like the following. And X tilde DM looks as follows. And the constraint is that the sigma tilde, which is 1 divided by T, X tilde DM transpose times X tilde DM is diagonal. Now let's look at the solution of that rotation problem. I define P to be a K times K rotation matrix. A rotation matrix can be any orthonormal matrix. That means that P transpose needs to be the identity matrix, and all columns of P are pairwise orthogonal. Hence, each column of P stands for an orthogonal direction in a K-dimensional coordinate system. I mentioned already here that an eigenvector matrix is also orthonormal because each column of an eigenvector matrix represents a coordinate of a 90-degree system. Okay, now the implication is that the rotation X tilde is simply a linear combination of the original X. Mathematically, it means that we are going to define X tilde DM as the original data XDM multiplied by this rotation matrix P. So the question now comes up, which P shall we choose? And clearly, we have a degree of freedom here. But we also have the constraint that a covariance matrix of x tilde shall be diagonal. So let's write that down. We want x tilde, we want a sigma tilde to be 1 divided by t x tilde dm transpose times x tilde dm. Now x tilde dm is nothing else than x dm times the rotation matrix p, which gives us the following expression. And we can now rewrite that as p transpose times sigma times p. So as sigma has its own eigenvalue decomposition, remember sigma is just e times lambda times e transpose, we basically end up that sigma tilde is nothing else than p transpose times e lambda e transpose times p. Now, we now need to choose p such that sigma tilde is diagonal. Now, one popular choice, and that's the choice of a PCA, is to set p equal to e. So our rotation matrix is simply the eigenvector matrix. Now, here's the reason. First, e is an orthonormal matrix. And second, if we choose E to be the rotation matrix, then sigma tilde will be diagonal. That's what we wanted. And maybe surprisingly, sigma tilde will not just be diagonal, but each of its diagonal elements is going to coincide with one of the eigenvalues of the original covariance matrix. Hence, here's the result. Sigma tilde within a PCA will coincide with lambda. So said differently now, the matrix of statistical risk factors equals x tilde dm, and that is nothing else than the original x dm multiplied by the eigenvector matrix. Now if E is sorted such that column 1 represents the eigenvector for the largest eigenvalue and column k represents the eigenvector of the smallest eigenvalue, then column 1 of x tilde dm is called PC1, or the first principal component. Now that is the most important principal component induced risk factor. And column k will be called PCK. That will be the least important principal component, or the kth principal component.